Hi everyone, welcome to this Twinmotion tips and tricks video. In the last two episodes, we had a look at how you can save objects and material inside your user library. In today's episode, we will be looking at the location of this user library and how you can share items with anyone. To find the location of your user library, you first need to click on this burger menu over here and click on Preferences. The shortcut is Ctrl+P. Once this panel is open, I will simply come to the Custom Path tab, and here I have the User Library folder. Let's open it. As you can see here, I am in my documents, Twinmotion 2020.2 User Library. With every new major release, a new folder will be created, but you can take all the items, all the folder that you have in your previous User Library folder and just simply paste them into the new Twinmotion version. Here, the hierarchy is the hierarchy you have set up inside your user library. So if I close that and if I come back to Twinmotion and enter my user library, as you can see here, I have the exact same hierarchy I have in my different folders over here. So context, materials, megascan, online, props, and Skydome. And here we have just one item that is in the middle of nowhere, that is not placed inside a folder. It's the Sky Dome that we imported previously in another tips and tricks video. As you can see here, when you save an object to your user library, it creates a .tmi file. This file is really the object, the materials. It's the object that you have inside your user library. This .tmi file, you can share it with anyone. Once the person you are sending this file to receive it, he simply needs to place it inside his user library folder. It's that simple to share any items inside Twinmotion. This .tmi file will be in the description of this video, so you can download it and place it in your own user library. This user library can also be shared on a network. If I come back to Twinmotion, click again on the Preference panel, Custom Path, here I can change the location of my user library folder. I'm working from home here, so I don't have the network of the office, but I have on just a basic USB drive, it can be any kind of drive. On this drive here, I have a folder with another user library that I created in a previous version of Twinmotion. Here, I will simply enter the user library folder and click on select and click on OK. And as you can see on the left here, my library has completely changed. It's not my previous library. This is the new library. And again, this folder can be located on my network and all my colleagues can pinpoint at this exact folder. So we are working with the same user library. So I think that's it for today. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to follow us for more content and see you for the next one. Bye everyone!